Waz has fingered Gagné, so police pull him in for questioning. He's someone they know well, a known drug dealer and a biker working his way up in the Hells Angels.
Gadas was a guy that he can scare you, he can do job like arm job, take a baseball bat, break a few legs. But to do that, you have to really, really, really love your boss. And this boss was Mambushi.
When the police arrested him late at night, brought him into an interrogation room, and the SQ's best interrogator, Rabel Pigeon, came in to begin a long interrogation that lasted almost 5 hours.
The pressure is on Pigeon. If he can break Gagné and get him to turn on Mambushi, police can stop the terror.
And the first thing that Gagné said was, of course, I'm not going to talk to you. And he demanded his lawyer. So, you know, the police are obliged to put the message through to his lawyer.
Pigeon has a plan. He starts with a friendly approach, talking about motorcycles and sports. But Gagné refuses to play ball. He is confident and cocky, an impenetrable stone wall. Pigeon changes tact. He harshly tells Gagné that his career as a Hell's Angel is over. He has screwed up. The bikers will never forgive him. For 3 hours, Pigeon applies pressure. It's 6:30 a.m., and Gagné is beginning to tire. There is no reply from his lawyer. Sensing the perfect opportunity, Pigeon drops the bomb. Police have a taped confession from Steve Boise. He has fingered Gagné as the prison guard killer. Gagné tries to remain defiant, but reality is seeping in. Had the Angels abandoned him? Was his use of Steve Boise a fatal error? What about the safety of his wife and son? Finally, Gagné asks to see the taped confession from Boise. After watching for 5 minutes, Gagné knows he's sunk.
And in the end, he realized that he was in a terrible bind, at a total corner, that no matter what, Steve Bois would be revealed as a guy who had participated, however indirectly, in these murders. And that Steve Bois would be the guy who would finger him. And that would be the end of Gagné. Gagné had no choice.
It is 8:10 in the morning. After 5 hours of interrogation, Gagné opens up like a river to the sea. Pigeon has done it. He has broken the killer who can lead the cops to Mambushi.
Gagné disclosed to the police that it was Mambushi, came up with the idea of killing the prison guards, ordered the killings, and that's why Gagné had carried them out. And he gave them chapter and verse.
The Crown prosecutor decided we had enough, and Mom was arrested.
With Gagné as their star witness, police arrest Mambushi for the murder of Diane Levine and Pierre Rondeau. Finally, police have Boucher behind bars. Now, their task is to convict him. It will be easier said than done. For starters, the Crown prosecutors are not well equipped.
We had no computers, and the staff is very, very limited. Like, we have a secretary for 20 attorneys.
And the Crown will need a corroborating witness, because Gagné is a lifelong criminal. Hardly a reputable individual. Only two people can support Gagné's testimony against Boucher. They are his accomplices in the murders, Fanfan Fontaine and Toots Toutsignan. But Mambushi has no intention of letting either one appear in court. To put Boucher away, police must find Fanfan and Toots. But that will be difficult.
with a bullet in his head, and he was burned. Not too much people know that, but I have the picture. So, and they were scared, and he turned around when Gadaz Gohani turned around with the murder of the two prison guards. So to make sure that he doesn't have a second witness, they kill him.
Toots was told, like, Fonfon, listen, get lost, go away, go hide, give a couple of hundred grand there and get lost. And Fonfon did, but Toots didn't. So they decided to kill him. And Toots ended up dead.
When they killed Toots, that sent a clear message. Be careful. Don't fuck with me.
The other key witness, Fonfon, heard Boucher's message loud and clear. He completely disappears. The assassination of Toots and the disappearance of Fonfon creates a serious problem for the prosecution.
There was not really any sort of corroboration.
It was easy for Boucher's lawyer to cut Gagné's credibility to shreds.
How awful it is that the Crown would indict someone like Mom Boucher on the testimony of a lowlife like Stéphane Gagné, who what horrible deeds he had done all his life, that he hadn't been truthful, that he had received welfare while he was making $5,000 a week dealing drugs. So basically he was saying, how can you believe someone who's been doing crimes, not only all of it, of his life, but practically every day or every week since he's 14 years old? And how can you believe such a person?
Stéphane Gagné swears that Mom Boucher ordered the hits to prove that he could do what he wanted, when he wanted, to prove that he was above the law. But Gagné is a tainted witness.
It wasn't very long. It was only a day or so before the jury came back with a not guilty verdict.
I remember it like it was yesterday. I still remember seeing the faces of these guys, Peltier, Abitaille, Charlebois, the whole gang of them, okay, coming down the steps with the mom on their shoulders, not understanding how they could be found not guilty, how he could have been found not guilty.
Mom Boucher was freed, and his persona, it just rose to the levels of almost a god in the criminal circles. This man had beaten an almost unbeatable charge. He must be a god.
Boucher is more untouchable than ever, and police are at an all-time low. They once made a deal with the devil, hoping to break Boucher with inside information. Now, the police will have to do it again.